most of the time people feel that one laboratory is right, another is wrong. But this is the case where I would say both could be right. Just want to tell you about positives and negatives separately. Positives, once positive, I would try and believe more on the positive compared to negative. One of the reason, in positives, you are doing first screening test, which is E antigen. And then you're doing confirmatory, whether it is N or S or RDRP and so on, or a combination of all. So actually when somebody is being labeled as positive, it is two tests done. It is doubly verified. So this is one very important factor. Second thing, when you check online all the literatures and even our own 5 months of experience of doing more than 4 lakh tests, false positivity do not happen. False positive is not an accident. False positive is not a possibility at all, not recorded at all. Positives, you should rely more. And I want to also add one example that we did one very large study of 10,000 patients within 10 days time, where two laboratories were asked to do the test. Same day, same patients collection happened two times. And the result differed. 6 to 7% of the result between both good laboratory, one where us and another was also a good laboratory, a CAP accredited laboratory, and result differed. And this was predicted before even the study started. And we also agreed that whoever gives positive, one has to rely on that, not on the negative. So I want to give a message that positives, do not feel it could be false positive. You rely more on positive. Coming to negative, there are n number of reasons why negative can come on a following sample. One, when you use different kit, you are detecting different antigen. The kit has got different sensitivity. That could be one analytical reason. But beside that, there are a lot of pre-analytical reason where patient sample when taken second time, either enough material did not come or the collection did not happen properly. Where when you take nasopharyngeal swab, person did not put swab properly inside and you did not get enough material to come positive. This is one of very common reason, collection. The second reason, which I would say that there is naturally post symptoms, the virus keep, viral load keeps declining. If you have tested positive and your viral load was at an absolute decline stage, in 2 to 3 days time also you can get negative. In fact, next day you can get negative. The paper show that post symptoms, 4.3 days average time in a good immunity individual, one can get negative second sample. And that's why most of the people say that 5 to 9 days is a period when you should repeat the test and you can run the test. So keep in mind that one virus is not there to stay in body for all time. One day it is going to decline, it is going to become undetectable. So these are few reasons where I would say that a positive report followed by a negative report, both being possible. So rely on both.